The Royal House Chapel International presents Power in His Presence.
Suggest to you that what you are going through, it is because there is oil on your head and the devil can't do anything about it. Clap your hands and say, I am going somewhere.
Praise the name of Jesus. Welcome to Power in His Presence. God bless you for joining us one more time. We are continuing the message we started last week titled Determination. And today we are going deeper with the Apostle General, and he's talking about why Jesus was successful in finishing his assignment. And then we will also speak about some of the qualities of a determined person. You don't want to miss this episode at all. Stay tuned. This is Power in His Presence. I'll be back in a few minutes to pray with you. God bless you. Most high, your hidden glory in creation now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. That
yeah.
are some qualities of determined people. Some characteristics of determined people. Number one, determined people are bold and courageous. They are bold and courageous. And we see that in Jesus Christ. When he arrived in Jerusalem, he went to the temple and he saw people were messing up the house of God. He said, how dare you people mess up the house of God like this? He began to whip them and drop them out of the place as though he owned the place. Meanwhile, himself is a visitor there. He had been ministering in Galilee throughout. He was entering into Jerusalem the first time. And look at the kind of authority he came to exercise. As if he owned the place. But that's his father's house. Boldness. Courage.
Yes, you are not can in Sempa or Galilee. No, everywhere in Jerusalem, they are kind. Send your see, Odia Kukudro, El Pamun Crawford, El Gun Crawfordjuma, Shasan Yosiano, Obexo Biawatra and Fiabri.
One thing that makes us so fearful is failure of the past.
Adiaba Kuma, a Kayan is there. Yadu Kuku Bebre, one Fiabi Etamu, it's a man who a Kayan.
The moment you are failed once, twice in your lifetime,
Wabrabumu, what did Kukushia Sabakumbi and Upe?
The devil uses your past failures as bargaining chip. Anytime you want to take a step, the devil says, again. Anytime you want to move, the devil says, Ebiom. When you start making a move, the devil says, Ekonlo. So your life has become stagnant at one place. Today, I move you forward in the name of Jesus. I move you from where you are to the place where you must be. Clap your hands and shout in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I am moving forward. I am moving forward. I will move forward. Therefore, you can't hold me again. Leave me alone. Clap your hands and say, break the chain.
Break the
yoke.
Break the yoke.
I am boss your name. And the invisible hand that is drawing you back. I break that pan. I curse that hand. I break it. I release the spirit of boldness into you and courage. Clap your hands and shout, I receive boldness. Prophesy to
somebody.
That's one of my spiritual daughters. I'll be sending her to some tough places. And anytime she goes to speak to the big men call me. And then they say, Apostle General, that your daughter is something else. I said, what happened? He says, hey, she doesn't take no for an answer. When she comes over, the way she comes to bully us with your name, I have been sent here by the Apostle General. He's asked me to come and give a message to your boss. Tell your boss, so and so is here in the name of the Apostle General. Hey, and the way she will impose my name, is the secretary will feel, Charlie, if she doesn't allow this girl to go and see the boss, she will lose her job. And then after that, the people will call me. I say, yeah, like father, like daughter. You must know who is working with you. You must know whom you have believed. And you must know who is your Lord and your Savior. Which Jesus Christ entered into Jerusalem with boldness and with courage. Even though he knew what was going to befall him. Receive boldness. From today, I rebuke the spirit of fear and timidity. Clap your hands and say, fear.
Yeah.
You are not of God.
You are not of God.
Get out
of my life.
My abose. My alabo katuri. Last time after service, one of my sons came to me and said, man of God, I'm dying. I said, what is wrong with you? He said, this, that. I said, but you are just from a very powerful service. Why are you dying? You will not die. Say that you will not die. Say, you won't die in front of me. You won't die in my house. You won't die on my altar. I won't bury you at your age. You will bury me in my old age. Are you hearing what I am saying? Yeah. Courage. Hey. Boldness. When you exercise courage and boldness, determination is working naturally. It's working.
Number 2.
Determined people, they have conviction and single-mindedness. Conviction and single-mindedness. Their mind is always one. I'm telling you, you can't play instrument for Apostle General for 50 years if you don't have the attitude of single-mindedness. Oh yeah, yeah, you can't. Because there are people who will come to you. Ah, Charlie, they've started this church. They give their instrumentalists a lot of money. They buy them cars. Here, I don't buy cars, but I give you life. Here, I don't buy cars, but I pay your school fees to go to school, and I give you degree so that you look for money yourself. If you don't have single-mindedness and conviction, you become a prostitute instrumentalist. Prostitute singer. Shabu shabu. Munchen. Your friend said Munchen. All my instruments are those who are playing for me for 25 years, 30 years. I've shown them leadership and I've shown them father's love. More than their biological parents. That's why they are here. Single-mindedness. People who are single-minded, they are determined people. Where do we see this in Jesus? As soon as he got to the temple and drove them away, he knew what his duty was. He said, where are the blind people? Where are the sick people? Come, let me do what I was doing in Galilee. I have come here in Jerusalem to do. This is my father's business.
Hi, I'm Rabbi Daniel Lappin, and I can't tell you how excited I am to be coming to teach in Ghana for the very first time this coming June. I shall reveal ancient Jewish wisdom secrets on wealth creation and make accessible to people of every background the tools and techniques that the people of Israel have effectively employed for generating money while serving other people, all of God's children. What makes this visit so special to me is not only that it is my very first time coming to Ghana, but also that I shall have the privilege of appearing together with my friend, Pastor John Sago of Switzerland, and also with Apostle General Sam Koranke Ankra, and together we will bring transformational teaching to all the people of Ghana. I am truly overflowing with enthusiasm for sharing with the people of this great nation. the ancient Jewish wisdom's spiritual strategies for financial abundance. I really look forward to meeting you all.
Number three, determined people are dedicated and they have willpower. You can't manipulate determined people. You can't lure them with money. You can't come and lie to them for them to believe. Determined people, you don't talk nonsense to them and they believe. Jesus, he was entering into Jerusalem and he knew what was going to happen to him. At Jerusalem, he was going to be arrested. He was going to be persecuted. He was going to be stripped naked. They were going to beat him. They were going to spit upon him. But he had the will, power. He was dedicated to his cause. He said, this is the reason why I came. I came to die for them. So if this is what will happen to me in my Jerusalem, let me enter. And today is entering to Jerusalem. We are celebrating as the triumphant entry. What triumph are you talking about? Death, resurrection, persecution. But in all your troubles, there is always a smell of victory. Can I talk to somebody? I said, in every trouble that you go through, there is always a window of opportunity and there is always a smell of victory. Who is this person I am talking to? Clap your hands and shout, I am the one. Let the devil hear you and shout again and say, I am the one. Can you tap somebody and say, there is victory in your problem? Tell somebody, there is victory. Tell somebody, there is triumph. There is triumph in all your persecutions. Shout, yes. Number 4, determined people are firm and focused. He said, get out of this house. My father's house is the house of prayer. You can't misbehave here. Pack your things and go. Determined people. They are firm. They are focused. Number 5. Determined people are persistent. They are persistent. He said, I'm going to ride a donkey. That's the prophecy concerning me. They didn't say, I'll ride on a horse. They said, oh, Israel, behold, your king cometh, riding on a donkey, humble as whatever.
And come say, oh, Israel, my name is Nebano. Now, dear Frumuso, ah, dear Frumuso, this is
your name. Your king is coming to you riding on the colt, humble. So what is written about me is that I must ride a donkey. I am a donkey man. Go to town. You see a donkey nobody is using. Untie that donkey. Bring him. And say, the master has need of that donkey. Tonight, I confess and I prophesy. Anyone that has been tied, your destiny tied, your future tied, clap your hands and say, loose.
Loose.
Oh, you are doing well. You are doing well. Clap your hands and say, loose, loose. Say, devil, loose my future. Loose my marriage. Loose my family. Loose my children. I command you. I say, clap my hands. Loose.
Loose.
Speak in tongues if you can. Don't say that you are not baptized. You are. Deal with the powers of darkness and principalities and spirits. Deal with them. Determined people are persistent. Be persistent in your desire. Be persistent in your prayer. Clap your hands. Loose your children. lose your marriage, lose your business, whatever that has been tied. Clap your hands and shout, loose.
Waka no ebebe mo, iradi waka no ebebe mo, iradi akase obe shiraye amayaye shira, besi waka no ebebe mo, di iradi wa. Kano ebebe mo, mani sune kase radi akase.
Loose, break loose. Kaya ipa swade riyale. Yakwata sabeke neri bika. Rudi biada bosi ata. Something is happening in the lives of this man. Loose your future. Loose your destiny. Break loose.
Efi se jo nyami. Onu na waka. Amayaye shira.
Prophesy.
Wow.
Come on, prophesy.
Hey. Iradi wakano. Ebebebo. Hey. Iradi akase. Obe shiraye. Obe shiraye. Amayaye shira.
Today I prophesy over your life. Anybody who has ignored you because you feel less important and they have tied you between two cities, between Bethany and Bethel, today I lose you. The master has need of you. The donkey in you is coming out. The prophecy in you is coming out. Clap your hands and say, I will fulfill my prophecy. Clap your hands and say, I will fulfill my assignment. Clap your hands and say, I'll fulfill my purpose. Wakano. Come on now. Come on, go to somebody. Come on, get up and go to somebody now. Prophesy to somebody. Professor to three people. Professor to four people.
Come
on, get up and go to
somebody.
Are you standing there? Why are you standing there? Come on, look for somebody. Look for somebody. Go and encourage somebody. Prophesy to somebody. Receive. You are losing. You are losing. You are losing. The donkey is coming. The donkey is coming. The donkey is coming. The donkey is coming. You are entering. You are going into your Jerusalem. Be determined. Receive. Determination,
Welcome back from the premises of Royal House Chapel, where the Apostle General has been blessing us with a powerful message titled Determination. Determination. I know that you are enjoying it, but I want you to know that this is not the end Next week, same time here on this program, we shall be continuing from where we left off. Thank you so much. Before I leave you, let me just pray for each and every family and individual that join us today for the spirit of determination. Shall we pray? Father Lord, I want to lift up each family and individual, everybody that is watching us today, who is receiving from the throne room of God. Father Lord, I pray that the spirit of determination shall rest upon them in the name of Jesus. I pray and I declare, anybody who's on the verge of giving up, anybody who has started a project, anybody who is on a journey of academics, of marriage, Father, give them the spirit of determination to finish the assignment and to finish well. We thank you, O Lord, that out of this ministration, testimony shall abound, miracles shall follow. People will receive an anointing that will cause them to run faster than they used to and do more and achieve more. We thank you, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, for what you're about to do. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. Thank you so much for joining us. This has been Power in His Presence. I'll see you same time next week here on this program. My name is Papa Crunchy Ankara. God bless you.